And it was more fun back then. Like now people are trying to like, you know, it's like freedom of speech is like people like act like they don't condone it. Like you can't say what you feel. You know what I'm saying? Which is stupid. So
I'm glad you brought that up, because it like the latest freedom of speech topic that's going around, you know, is I don't know if it's controversy or it's what Rick Ross said on one of his tracks, you know, the you don't even know it joint. Mm-hmm. Yeah. I mean, do you, as an artist, you know, and I do want to know your opinion on the actual lyric of Rick Ross, but do you feel like, A, people are, you know, take the actual words too seriously? Like you said, it's just an art. You're just throwing paint on a blank canvas and that's what comes out. And, you know, is it just like you're kind of writing pictures similar to how a movie director would?
I think it's the same time. It's like, you know, like we all got friends that's been in jail or that done stuff, that sold drugs or whatever, anything like that. But, you know, sometimes you got to be the voice for them people. Yeah. And a lot of that, and that's what rap is. Like, you know what I'm saying? Even what Pac did, like, you know what I'm saying? Like, Pac would talk about having kids and his baby mama getting on his nerve, but he didn't, I mean, like that stuff, he was talking about what was going on. He was a voice.
Yeah.
And I think that's what it is. Like, you know, and the thing, like, people, you know, like rap is, hip hop rap is like the most influential culture over any genre of music. I don't care what you say. Like, absolutely. Everybody wants to be a rapper. Everybody wants to dress like us, to talk like us, and have that freedom like we have. But at the same time, it's like the most negative culture. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Because like, not only will we make it, but like other people outside of it. And for them to like talk to Ross, and I seen that, like they petitioned like in front of a Reebok store.
Yeah,
like, I mean, what he said, like, I mean, it's freedom of speech. Like, it wasn't even his record. You know what I'm saying?
It was a feature.
So for them to do all that off of a mixtape song that wasn't even his, is kind of like, I mean, you just got those groups, you know what I mean? It's like, they just want to, you know,
petition.
Yeah, it's time to petition. So they call the number. They don't even know what they're petitioning for. I think like people just, you know, activists and all those righteous groups, and you know, that's what they do. You know what I'm saying? They probably don't even listen to Ross music, but it's just like,
yeah,
I know they don't know who Rocco is. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's just, they just, you know, finding anything they can.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And I wanted to speak on that because this weekend I'm performing at Harvard, which is, you know, one of the most prestigious
schools
and universities in the world.
Absolutely.
And I guess there's a group on campus that are protesting to not have me perform.
Really?
Because of my lyrics. And, you know, they say I promote sexism and rape culture. So I read the letter.
Damn.
And it was funny because it's like, I mean, why would you, I mean, but this is just a group.
This isn't
the whole student union.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? The people that booked me to come to the show are like, they, you know, they're fans. You know what I'm saying? They want me to perform at their school, but then you have a group. So it's always going to be like, I mean, people opposite. It's always going to be wars
of anything. People's opinions.
Yeah,
and
so
all
it's
that.
Like, at the end of the day, like, People have the right to have opinions. I have the right to have an opinion, and I have the right to say what I want on my music, because it's my music.
Yeah, absolutely.
If you don't like it, don't click on it. Don't download it.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? But
yeah.
I think it's just getting out of hand with the whole, like just people looking into it too much. You know what I'm
absolutely.
Saying? People just need to really focus on, I think, like, you know, it's just social media. You know what I'm saying?
And One thing that I thought you hit on so well is like you said, like y'all are the voice for a lot of people that either you know or people you know. And that's really how I took what Ross said. I mean, as much as I don't condone anything like that, and Ross has gone on record and said the same thing.
Right.
There's people out there living that life, you know, drinking, smoking, Molly, partying,
and
killing, whatever.
It.
You know what I'm saying?
You know
what
I'm saying?
And I think that's really the underlying message.
All music is not positive, and all, you know what I'm saying? Like, I can admit I make negative music, but I also make positive music because that's what's thrown at me with life. You know what I'm saying? Is your goods and your evils. You know what I mean? So
hey, it's real, man. Well, look, Tyga, I appreciate you coming on the show today, man. Thank you so much. Congratulations on Hotel
appreciate
California.
It, man. Hotel California in stores, man. Right
this is
now.
Exciting. This is exciting.
I said, fuck the mother niggas, cause I'm down for my niggas.
What?
Fuck the mother niggas, cause I'm down for my niggas.
What?
Fuck the mother niggas, I ride for my niggas, I die for my niggas. Nigga, I hit 'em up.